out some new parts today.
Dual 2.5 inch inlet, single 3 inch outlet. Power steering pump was what was ticking, and it got real bad when I went for my second drive. And so I got me a new one of these, and holy cow, these are expensive. Be careful. I got the 96 to 98 Explorer Mountaineer dipstick, because they are different lengths, I guess, in 99. And I got a 195 thermostat and a 210 195, if I can get you in the camera, 210 195 electric fan thermostat switch, because the one that I currently have on here is a 180 or 185, and that's just not going to work. It's going to be turning the electric fan on way too early. And I did purchase a dual core radiator for a 95 to 97 Ranger, and that should be coming in here in the next couple days. And I also got a e-fan to be a puller or pusher depending on where it'll fit. And this guy is really neat because it just controls the ground for the fan wire. Positive wire goes straight to the battery, and this controls the negative on it. I may end up putting a little relay on the firewall here, but my buddy, he said he's been running his like that for a long time. And this aftermarket China thermostat housing is leaking, so I gotta find my factory one. I hope I didn't throw it away or scrap it, because supposedly they don't fit right if they're not factory, and they will always leak. And the coolant passage here doesn't line up with the inside intake coolant passage, so hopefully I can take that off and be able to put some sealant on it and put it back and have it work, or find the factory one and then drill it out and install this guy here. Next thing, I'm taking a cool little air conditioning delete bracket and pulley to take off the AC compressor to put that on that truck, because that AC compressor is bad. And the clutch fell off of this one at some point, so I'm gonna have to rob the clutch off of one of my other AC compressors. But yeah, this is pretty easy. I got the belt off. It's easier to do from the bottom with a serpentine belt tool. I got it loose. I'm gonna remove the 4 10-millimeter bolts. And the kit came with some spacers and bolts. Here we go. Now that I got the compressor off, I tapped in these little sleeves with a hammer very lightly, and that'll take up the slack in the bolt holes on the new bracket. I did have to install the provided spacer because the pulley wasn't far out enough, but pretty easy. All right, got it on there. It's pretty lined up. It looks like with the spacer, it might be just a tad too long, but without the spacer, it's a little too short and closer to the block. I slid the bracket as far back as I could with the spacer in, and it's freaking close. So I may take the spacer out and take a couple thousandths off of it, or probably a little more than that, and then put it back in there just to get it all perfectly lined up. But there it is. The AC delete bracket installed. I ran it and the pulley seems to be fine. I got the new dual core 4.0 95 to 97, 18-inch wide radiator. As you can see, this one is missing this front half, and this one is full. So I'm gonna see how this thing fits with the manual fan off, and I have a 16-inch electric fan mounted to this one, and I'm gonna hopefully, I mean, it wasn't overheating as it was. It was staying just below, you know, midway on the temperature, and I drove around in 100 degree Texas heat all yesterday, and it stayed like that even with some poles. So I'm gonna put this on there just in case, and the thermostat's gonna be a 195 for the engine and a 210 195 or 195 210 guy here for the electric fan. That's gonna be the ground, and my thermostat housing decided to stop leaking, but I'm gonna take it apart right now, and I'm gonna put it together with some special stuff that a guy from O'Reilly's gave me, and see if that keeps it from leaking. You can see that. It's making contact right there, so I'm gonna have to trim it a little bit. There you have it. It's in there. Just gonna fill it up. I actually didn't need to trim that. When I pulled it close enough to put the bolts in, it's still got about a 16th of an inch gap in there. If I ever need to take it out, I may bend it slightly, but it fits, so all I have to do is run the power wires for this guy, and I'm all set. I'm being a good boy this time. I think it's probably gonna be the first time I've ever filled up a vehicle with all coolant bought from the store. And get you guys one of these kits. Comes with a little ring and an adapter that fits everything. And then this guy stops the flow. When you're full, you can put that on there and then pull this off and then put your radiator cap on and not spill fluid everywhere. It's pretty cool.